This is going to be a video series detailing how to assemble the DX Commander Classic antenna. The package arrived yesterday, and as you can see, the antenna pole is about 4 feet long. Then we have a bag with a lot of equipment and parts, and another little box that's got the plates, and then a bunch of wire coiled up into a roll, and this extra packaging material. I've gone ahead and, just to see how this fits, taken off the bottom cap and put in the bottom plate. That's the one with the L-shaped fitting for the coax, for the feed point, and then the driven plate, just to see how it fit. That is where my starting point is. By the way, the antenna comes with this little plastic guard that goes on top that I intend to keep because it seems to be a nice addition to keep the antenna from getting scratched, or the antenna pole from getting scratched. Okay, I've gone ahead and taken the main package and taken the scissor to the top of the package, and as you can tell, opened it up. There's a lot of little pieces in here, so be careful that they don't spill out. I've gone ahead and carefully taken out my washers, these bolts, they're all the same size, and then these wing nuts, they seem to be all the same diameter. And also I've gone ahead and taken out these hose clamps, and they are of different sizes, so be aware. You have a couple of these large ones and some middle ones and some small ones. So anyway, separating these out, and the next thing to do now is to try to go ahead and put these bolts and nuts and washers onto the respective plates. Next, we're going to be cutting the elements according to the length specified by Callum. I've got the extreme of an element pinned here with a couple of weights, my measuring tape in inches running right across it, parallel to it, and I'm over here ready to cut this cable right here. So at this point, I'm cutting the cable after measuring it, and after that, I'm going to go ahead and place it right here on the 17 meter area, showing the measurements in centimeters and in inches to double check. Same thing for the 20 meters that I've already done, 30 meters and 40 meters. This way I'm double checking my measurements and making sure that I've cut the right length. If anything, I might have erred a little bit on the plus side, maybe a tenth of an inch, maybe not even a quarter of an inch long. I went ahead and measured 19 lengths of 3.5 meters, or 12 feet, right around 12 feet, 11 and a half feet of the wire, and that is going to be my radio array. So essentially I just held it around this loop right here with my measuring tape in inches and went around some weight at the other end. So I'm going to cut there and cut here, and that should go ahead and give me my radials. I'll see how that works. I might have to get more radials in the future, but 19-20 radials should be plenty. For the next part of the project, I've gone ahead and made 4 groups of 5 radials each and bundled them together, tinned the bundle, and then put one of these yellow connectors on that bundle. Then I went ahead and soldered the inside of this area right here using a soldering iron at low power. This one shows to be at about 250 degrees C, and that right there pretty much soldered that in there and let that cool off. So I've got 4 of these type of connections. Similarly, I did a similar process over here with the elements. You can see the blue connector, and again, I stripped it. See my wire strippers here, and then went ahead and tinned the connection and applied solder in here to reinforce that connection. So my elements are ready, my radials are ready. Let's go on outside and start putting this antenna together. We are now ready to go ahead and put together the DX Commander multi-element vertical antenna out here in the backyard. So over here we have our radials, and they are five radial wires bundled together. So that's radial array number one, that's five wires, each one is 3.5 meters. Radial array number two, again five wires, each one is 3.5 meters, bundled together into that yellow connector. Array number three and array number four. Up here, as shown before, we have our element wires with a blue connector at the very end, and I've also labeled them with little masking tape indicators showing what band they correspond to. And again, the measurements are in centimeters and in inches, just to double check. Those are the spacer plates right there. They're made of some sort of, I don't know, acrylic maybe. And they, according to Callum, they're water jet cut. And these over here are the hose clamps that I've threaded the protective tubing on them so that they don't damage the DX Commander pole. And over here we have the main plates. That's the driven element plate, and that's the radial plate with the SO239 connector and my little amalgamated tape job there. So that's what we have there. And over here we have the DX Commander pole. We're going to go ahead and pop the top of it. And of course it's a telescoping pole, so we'll be extending it. I expect it'll go from there to that chair and that chair. And the idea is to go ahead and put everything together and show what that looks like. After putting together the plates on the bottom, securing them with hose clamps, putting hose clamps in between there and the plates and in between the plates and so on, that's what the DX Commander is looking like. And now what I've done is I've gone ahead and threaded the elements, and as you can tell, we've got the 40, 30, 20, and the 17 meter elements off of the driven plate. I've also gone ahead and fastened the coax connector onto the driven plate there. And at this point, we're ready to start tightening up these lines and seeing how it goes. The DX Commander has now been assembled. We have the element wires stretched. I've gone ahead and put in the guy wire connections. I've put them this way so as not to put that connection in a bind and give it a little bit of play when it tensions. And you can see all the lines up here. I followed Mike K8MRD's video on how to adjust this. I'm just going ahead and put in masking tape right now to hold my elements in case I have to cut or hopefully not solder any additional length. But this is what I'm going to start trying out. And these are all the elements, 17, 20, 30, 40. And that's the bungee cord right there to go ahead and apply a little bit of tension. Not much, but a little bit of tension there. And then the only question mark that I have is this top connection, which is for the 40 meter element. As you can see, the original design calls for quite a bit of slack, or what I measured was left quite a bit of slack out. So that might be a mistake or might be something that I need to trim later. But of course, it's better to have too much line. I can always trim that back as opposed to going through the hassle of soldering. Okay, so next I'm going to go ahead and use these tent stakes that I got at Academy and see if I can raise this antenna. Put two at once and then raise the antenna and put the third one up. We'll see how it goes. So that's the first time raising of the antenna. The guy wires are spaced about, and I've purposely put it in between these trees, although it's not touching anything, so it's okay. There's a few details to address. I might want to do something down here to go ahead and make sure that it stabs the ground a little bit better. Maybe put a stake there. And also my wires are a little bit
helical, not much, but I want them parallel. And there you go, 30-foot DX Commander Expedition. I'm sorry, DX Commander Classic. We'll see how this plugs in and works.
This is the DX Commander working with an icom IC7300 on 40 meters. When we do a frequency sweep here, we notice that the antenna is resonant on 40 meters without the tuner applied. On 20 meters, increasing the gain a little bit just to see more signals, we do another frequency sweep. And the antenna is again resonant at 15% power. So the antenna is definitely resonant on multiple frequencies as it is. And then say for example, in 15 meters, which is an odd multiple of the 40 meter band as expected, we're resonant in the 17 meter band. We have the tuner on, but other than that, we are also resonant. Had to turn on the tuner. If I turn off the tuner, we're slightly over 1.5 to 1. So I'm probably going to have to do some trimming on the 17 meter element. But all in all, the antenna is working very much beyond expectations as far as resonances and as far as the number of signals that we're getting. The strength of the signals and compared to a baseline on a dipole antenna that I have here in the yard, this one is performing very well also. All in all, I'm very hopeful about the DX Commander. It's a positive antenna. The build was a lot of fun. And well, more results will be coming as I try to see how far I'm getting at, where these signals are actually coming from. Preliminary results are that I'm able to get, 1,000 miles, 1,200 miles regularly. But again, probably a whisper survey of signals or FT8 will tell me more about the range of signals that I'm getting. That concludes this series of presentations on the assembly project for the DX Commander Classic antenna.